Without further ado, I give you Legally Blonde Jr.
Oh, so dreams make true. Up in the future of play. It's time to get serious. Time to get serious with you.
I've never thought that I.
Honey, I'm not finished.
Oh, sorry.
Here we go. Gotta wake up and take our journey. Serious. I'm telling you, as future is certain. You want them in the sky. Then say, don't be shy. Baby, that's. Miss L. Woods,
who was kind enough to send in a headshot.
Oh. It says here she has a 4.0 average.
Yes, in fashion merchandising.
And she has a 175 on her LSATs.
There's also a letter of recommendation from Oprah Winfrey.
I'm not arguing Miss Woods is entirely unqualified, because she didn't even bother sending in a personal essay.
Fit for a personal essay!
Move up.
Is this my social
No, you're academic. We're just going around the room. Tell us something about yourself.
Me? Okay. I'm a Gemini with a double Capricorn moon. I have a bachelor's degree from UCLA, where I was Seg X sweetheart, president of the Delta Nu sorority, and founded the charity Shop for Cause.
Oh, I don't think dogs are exactly allowed in class.
Oh, Brewster's not a dog. Brewster's family. Oh my gosh, Leonard, that's so weird. I totally forgot. You go here.
What are you doing?
I go here.
You got into Harvard?
What, like it's hard?
We're just starting class. Everybody take a seat. Callie should be here any second. 3 years ago, I was sitting where you're sitting, and I've heard the rumors. I'm sure you've heard too. Callahan's ruthless. What you really need to know is...
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you. When you choose a career in law, you're bound to hear that a lawyer is a shark. Ignore that. It's simplistic and stupid. Only some of you will turn out as sharks. The rest are sharks. What's my point? I'll tell you. In this class, I will hire 4 young sharks to join my $1 billion law firm as interns for me, virtually guaranteeing a career. If you can survive. Now, Miss...
Woods! Elwoods!
Looks like someone's had their morning coffee. Could you come write the case favoring the Adler's term for the reasons?
Okay, I'm assigned to reading for the first day of class. No, I'd throw her out.
Hey, Woods, come on. I was kicked out of class once, first year too. It was awful, but trust me, your law career is not over.
Law career? So not the problem. Listen, I need to get back into class with Warner.
You can come back tomorrow and make sure you've done your reading.
Okay. Excuse me? Why would you do that?
Do what? You came to class unprepared, not me.
Us girls gotta stick together. We shouldn't try to look good by making each other look bad.
Well, maybe you should read a law book sometime.
So I'll give you ladies a moment then.
Hey.
Oh, yeah, thank gosh you're here.
Elle, I'm sorry.
Sorry about what? Wonder, is this something like the share with Elle?
Yeah, Elle, Vivian and I went to boarding school together, and she's my girlfriend now.
I'm sorry. What did you say?
He said I'm his girlfriend.
Girlfriend?
My grandfather came from descended from poets and kings. So I swore I'd get married in Ireland, get a wedding like Lord of the Rings. And my redheaded groom I can sing of, as we stroll past the churches and farms. He's a sailor named Brendan Wadleyo. He can dance without moving his arms.
It's not called C-minus Callahan for nothing.
Warner, I'm completely cognizant of both those facts.
You're not gonna make it through this semester, let alone Callahan's internship. Face it, bunny, someday we'll nominate him for justice and you'll tan.
Thanks for your great tip on this year's costume party. I see you came as last year's sample sale.
Came out here to follow a man. Harvard Law was just part of that plan. Man, what rich romantic planet are you from?
Malibu?
Instead of lying outside by the pool, you stalk some guy to an Ivy League school? That's the weirdest reason I'm...
Why'd you come?
Okay. I grew up in the Roxbury slums with my mom and a series of bums. Guys who showed me all the ways a man could fail. I got through Harvard, I worked like a fool. Worked two jobs in addition to school. So forgive me for not weeping at your tail.
I'm sorry, just because you got some kind of chip on your shoulder?
You know what? You're right. There's a chip on my shoulder, as big as a boulder. With a chance I didn't give it, I got me driven to excel. I'm so close I can taste it, so I'm not gonna waste it. Yeah, there's a chip on my shoulder, you might wanna get one as well.
I'm sorry, that just sounds highly negative.
Hey, I'm just being honest. When you weren't born in privilege, you gotta work twice as hard.
Wait, 2 years before summer school?
I haven't slept in 6 years.
So I just need to prove to everyone that I'm serious.
What you need is to get to work.
Contracts can be expressed first, Railroad versus U.S. versus 1923. Once the pirates began their show, even for a second, the contract was in fact implied. Pirate parties are tragic, but the mother still has to pay.
Miss Woods?
Oh my gosh!
I assume you need to find a relationship. Do you have a resume?
Yes. Here you go. Thank you so much for your consideration.
Dear God, it's sexy.
She was so good to see you there. I'm just happy I could be there. First thing says that she ain't new. She's so close, she can taste it. She's got chip on her shoulder. Never can tell.
Thank you. Brooke Windham, and welcome to the Windham Workout This Suit Challenge, and our commitment to being the best that you can be.
Yeah!
So grab your cardio whip 5000, because if you want to get ripped, you have to get whipped.
Do you want an easy miracle, or do you want to lose a pound or two? Then you can turn this off right now, my workout's not for you. I'm talking to the one who wants it all, gotta pay for what you get. Besides your clothes, don't come to those who lazy to sweat. I want you whipped into shape. When I say just say how hot, you'll know you're doing it right. When you start to cry, if you don't look like you should, you've got to whip it, whip it, whip it good. I'm sorry ladies, no escape till you're whipped into shape. Come on Sabrina, work it out. Whipped into shape.
She's made tons off her DVDs and book. Whip your way into tighter buns. Happily married, so she swears, to her 60-year-old stud, till stepdaughter came downstairs and found Brooke all covered in his blood. Hands, who thinks she's guilty? Okay, here's where you please come in. Brooke has trouble trusting me. I'm her only chance to win, but I don't speak MVP. No, Brooke won't offer her defense. She may listen to her fears, so go and place a little sense in the space between her ears. Not now. I want her whipped into shape. If there's a brain in that head, tell it that I am the key. It's a plea or the chair. See, when I talk to her, I can neither plea nor plan nor alibi. To quote from our defense tape, I want her whipped into shape.
But that involves an alibi.
I can't tell it.
Why not? Everyone has their secrets. For years I denied my highlights.
It's beyond highlights, Elle. My secret is nuclear, and if it gets out, I could lose my fitness empire, which means everything to me. But if I tell you, you Delta Nu sisters swear not to tell anyone else.
I will double Delta Nu sister swear.
Okay. On the day that my husband was killed, I had...
Lipo.
What?
Lipo.
Brooke, you're gonna have to speak up. I can't...
Liposuction!
Minimally invasive outpatient lipo, butt lipo!
Oh my gosh.
I had to do it.
Your secret's safe with me.
My fans are counting on me and I can't let them down, so you gotta take care of me, Elle. You swore!
Elle, there you are.
I got her alibi.
You're kidding. What is it?
I'm afraid I cannot tell you.
Why?
But I gave Brooke my word. I doubled up some new sisters for not to.
Elle, this is not some sorority thing.
Oh, I know. It's a big sorority thing. But think about it. Brooke's a fitness queen. Exercise gives her endorphins. Endorphins make you happy. Happy people don't just kill.
Emmett, a word.
Elle, if you don't give this alibi, we will all lose the case.
Then I guess we're not very good lawyers then.
Who bear? Elle. Callahan wants that alibi.
But I gave up my word.
And let me be clear. This is your chance, and I need simple instructions. Leave this legal team and get me an alibi! You're zero, you're two. All right, everyone. Let's go. Field trip's over. Except for you two. I'd rather not be red or legally blonde again today.
I'm sorry.
I don't need you. Sorry, Elle. I need you to tell me the alibi.
But I keep up my word. Having an alibi isn't the only way to win this case.
No, but I'm sure it would help.
Well, if we work the white way, the noble way.
This isn't a lifetime version movie, Elle. I'm not interested in nobility right now. I'm more interested in saving Brooke's life.
No, you're not. You're more interested in impressing Callahan.
Well, he is my boss, and if I impress him, he'll make me associate.
We're free Brooke right. Come on.
Any luck with that guy you like?
No.
Ah, that's sad.
They're all over me to give up Brooke's alibi.
Including your friend, Emmett?
Paulette, he's just my friend.
Right, and I could use a friend like that.
Thank you.
mine. You have no idea how much I've learned. Thank you.
What you learn isn't the point. You've got instincts. And instincts, if you go otherwise, can't be taught. Trust your instincts.
Is this the only reason why you gave me the internship?
I thought you were better than that. You can show yourself out.
Honey,
You're in the supply closet.
I know. I said I'm wearing that again. I'm wearing this.
Come on.
going to the gauntlet and completely ruins it. It's a cargo port for maintenance. Your permit's still intact, so you couldn't have showered that day. Why would you lie about being in the shower? Why would you lie about not hearing the gunshot? Why would you?
You think I like being older than my dad's new wife? I didn't mean to shoot my father. I didn't mean to hurt anybody. I thought it was Brooke coming through the door.
Who helped me to prevail?